you had to schedule and reschedule all your schedules and reach here. So I was in Gujarat for last 3 days. Happened to be in Dwarka as well as Somnath for darshan, and the rains following everywhere. To an extent that all of us in Rajkot know how it poured yesterday night. It was heavily, roads were heavily flooded, and we could not go to the railway station to receive, sir. We are sorry for that, sir, but we are really happy that you are here on our campus, and as you say that it is your dream, always had been your dream to come on Sourashtra University campus as well as this region. Welcome, sir. I would request Professor Damodaran to felicitate our Vice Chancellor Neela Bribin the way. In fact, madam.
Sahitya Sadas, all right, give another song that they have wrote.
And in fact, madam gave us a special time to visit, and we visited our office of the Vice Chancellor day before yesterday with a group of resource persons from Madurai. Damodaran ji who insisted that no, we publicly want to felicitate madam. So I'm sure that your stay here, this 7 days, has been quite comfortable, and we also planned for darshan to Dwarka, Somnath, that too you enjoyed, and probably the atmosphere that we have these days, rains might have been a hurdle, but we are all here, and welcome to the gathering once again. Thank you all.
I'm certain that Sourashtra vocabulary workshop, which has been a learning experience for all of us, will mean a lot to scholars and the society. It is the efforts put in the working session by our resource persons that we have been able to accomplish it successfully today. There were 15 resource persons from Sourashtri as well and Gujarati each. I would now request a representative from each group to share their experience with us. May I call upon Professor L. R. Govardhanan, resource person Madurai, followed by Dr. Molly Kiras, assistant professor, Government Engineering College, Bhuj, to come on the dais and give their valuable remarks.
Respected dignitaries on the stage and this august gathering here, a very good morning to you all. I have been given just 2 minutes, that's why I have to be very short. We are very happy that this Triveni Sangam, as our Professor Jala mentioned, has successfully organized and accomplished our task of enlarging the vocabulary, the Sourashtri vocabulary, in the form of a dictionary which will be compiled, adding more and more words, gradually more and more words to the existing vocabulary dictionaries. So I'm quite sure that all of you would have noted all the resource persons and especially the faculty members and the student friends here. They have been busy as a bee, working hard, discussing a lot, and even with taking a lot of care about the nuances of words so that precision can be achieved in the addition of words, precise meanings, precise usage, etc., adding sentences and all that. So it was a very pleasant experience for all of us, and this is the right time for us to, for us, for the people from Madurai, from the community people from Madurai, the resource persons from Madurai, to extend our hearty thanks to all the organizers here, as to the Sourashtra University, our VC, our Professor Zala, our Prem Kumar ji from Mysore CIL, and our, of course, our own Damodaran ji, Professor Damodaran, who has spearheaded this literary movement by publishing books and organizing lots of meetings in Madurai. So we are happy that it's a three-folded sphere marching towards a common goal, and we have been fortunate to participate in this national workshop on Sourashtri vocabulary development. So thank you, sir, for all the support you have given, the cooperation you have given, and thanks for the nice accommodation arrangements and also for the tour arrangements you have given, making our stay here and our work here very pleasant. Thank you so much.
Honorable dignitaries on the base, respected invitees, my respected teachers, colleagues and friends and students. Good morning to all of you. It was a wonderful event and a very ambitious project as such. Well, India has been the land of lexicography. And perhaps one of the finest and the first examples in the world of letters come from India in the form of Nirukta and Halayut Kosh. Even in Gujarati, we have this Bhagavad Gita Mandal, which boasts of 2.81 lakh lexical entries, about 28,000 idioms, 10,000 proverbs, and the work went on for about 30 years and it's some mammoth task. It's indeed.
Please carry on, sir.
So indeed, we do have a rich heritage of lexicography. And this is one feather added to that. A couple of observations on our work. Well, we were thrilled, enthused. This is new project of its kind. And that we share such linguistic and cultural affinity of language with people who are residing in South, in the parts of Madurai, Chennai, Mysore, and other cities. So, coming to the building of dictionary is essentially a yeoman service that we may render to the language, because this is documentation. And we may not be there after 50 or 100 years, but this will survive. Now, what I felt is that as participants, it could have been mutually beneficial to all of us had we secured some list of words in advance so that we come prepared and then there are entries and we are there to deliberate on. That could have saved us some time and we could have been a little more exact with our work. Number two, about finding the words, we do have models with us. We do have dictionaries in Sourashtri language, dictionaries in Gujarati. Of course, people would have thought about this. So, about the lexical entries, if we go by the letters, then probably we have grammatical and prefixes, suffixes, words, nouns, adjectives, all the parts of speech would be taken care of. Along with the colloquial, formal, informal, and cultural and literary words would be part of it. So we would not have to invest our energies distinctly on all of these. So that would save us some time, and we may have some model. Professor Chotalia ji, he would know more about the work of Halayut Kosh, which is one of its kind in the world, where thesaurus, dictionary, reference book and morphological explanations all are rolled into one. Even Oxford and Cambridge have not come out with such model. We do have it. Can we have this model in its advanced stage? You know, right now we may be just the initiators in this work, but later on we may aspire to come to this level where we can have a dictionary, thesaurus, morphological entries and reference books, references rolled into one. So this would be fantastic. I know this is something long, arduous, time-taking, perhaps lifelong project, but worth a shot of one's life. So I'm really thrilled, and I hope some more rigorous and serious work comes out of our drill. Thank you very much.
So, guest of honor, Professor Joshipura sir is with us, Professor Kamalesh Joshipura. Sir, we are happy that you could make it today. There were schedules and reschedules of the valedictory, and finally, you are here with us in the session. I would request Prem Kumar to felicitate sir with us all.
I am Prem Kumar.
Professor Kamalesh Joshipura has been our Vice Chancellor for two terms in Sourashtra University, as well as former Vice Chancellor, Children's University, Gandhinagar, and above all, more than that, his affiliation with Sourashtra Heritage Chair. Sir visits South India almost every month. So we can imagine of his affiliation with the people in Madurai and around, Sourashtra people. It was during his tenure that Sourashtra Heritage Chair was established and all the activities were charted out. And sir, I'm proud to tell you that these activities have gone on, and
yes,
probably this third workshop that we are having today in the valedictory session that you are here to witness has come up with as many as 3,000 words in the 7 days. Welcome, sir.
Ajay.
So you got the chance.
We as hosts take this opportunity to have the response of CIIL coordinator Dr. Prem Kumar to give us brief about the workshop.
A very good morning to all of you. I feel very proud to be a coordinator, one of the coordinators of the program on behalf of CAL. As I pointed out in the inaugural session, the language has become endangered. I feel like that it's becoming endangered. So we have to document it, that language. In this workshop, we have collected around 2,500 words. I feel very proud to say that on behalf of CAL. And today we have Foundation Day function at CAL. I am very happy to be here. At the same time, we are conducting this validity function as well as the Foundation Day function of the CAL. I never feel that the people who are coming from Madurai, they have worked hard. Really, I'm proud that because their physical appearance may be looking old, but their mind is very young. They work actively. They have collected 2,500 words on this occasion. The language has been, as I pointed out, that the language has been already, they lost, the younger generation, they lost many vocabularies. And also all the linguistic aspects, linguistic feature also they have lost. When you see that in Madurai dialect, we have seen at least we have 4 or 3 PNG markers. Like agreement, we have agreement with subject and verb. When you compare with Gujarati languages, we don't have like Saurasya doesn't have that object and verb agreement. We have lost that linguistic feature. I feel like that is there, sir. Gujarati have object and verb agreement.
Yes.
It might be there because, but in Saurasya doesn't have object and because we don't have neuter items. Neuter mean that a particular item. We don't have feminine and masculine gender. They have table. Maybe they have masculine form chair. Maybe in a feminine form. But in Saurasya doesn't have. I feel like that when I discussed with the Damodaran sir, he said that the handa handi. It may be a feminine. E form it's denotes a feminine form. A form denotes a masculine form. I feel like that, but we don't have object, subject, object and verb. We cannot say that is has feminine and masculine differentiation. I don't want to take much time, so. I have been given 10 minutes, 2 minutes for total. So, as I'm a linguist, I want to say something more on language, but I don't have time to discuss on this time. So, they have provided good accommodation and as well as good hospitality. I'm very proud to be part of this program. I'm very much thanks to organizer. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, sir. I feel happy to invite our guest of honor, Professor Kamalesh Joshipura, Honorable Former Vice Chancellor, Sourashtra University, Rajkot, our mentor, who has always been with us since the inception of Sourashtra Heritage Chair during his tenure as the Vice Chancellor, Vice Chancellor of this university. I request you, sir, to address the gathering.
Thank you so much. Esteemed dignitaries sitting on the dais, most respected and honorable acting Vice Chancellor of Sourashtra University, Professor Nilambari Ben Dave, Chief Guest, Additional Director General of Police, Andhra Pradesh, KRM Kishore Kumar Ji, CIL Coordinator Mr. Dr. Prem Kumar, our Dada, brand philosopher and guy, Sri Dr. Damodaranji, a person who contributed a lot in the area of such kind of activities, Professor Ravi Singh Jala sir, my senior colleague Professor Kamal Mehta sir, head of the department, my friend Professor Jaydeep Singh Dodia, head of the department from the history, Prafulla Ben, dear friends, of course, it's a matter of great pleasure for me to be with you. Really, Mr. Jalaji has rightly mentioned about my frequent visit to the Tamil Nadu. And I am very much happy to share with you that on coming Saturday, our Saurashtrian brothers and sisters have invited me to attend the convocation program of Saurashtra College. Rather, it is on 21st of July. While connected with the some universities in Tamil Nadu, Chandrasekharendra Saraswati University, Priest University and other universities, our state universities. Whenever I visit Tamil Nadu, I used to grab the opportunity to meet our brothers and sisters. Madura is the headquarter of our brothers and sisters. Dear friends, as Prem Kumar has rightly mentioned about the real threat upon the classical Indian languages, as far as Saurashtrians, what they call it as the Saurashtrian, there is a difference in spelling. We used to start it from SAU, and our brothers and sister used to start it with SOU. But at the same time, after the gap of almost 1100 years, still our brothers and sisters have maintained their own identity with all kind of rituals, with all kind of cultural heritage, and at the top they have maintained, they have preserved their language. I could observe that as far even Gujarati people, we used to speak Gujarati day to day, but we have started mixing English words in our Gujarati language. So if our mothers, they are strict about this, then the language can be protected. But unfortunately, in Gujarat, whatever may be the reason, I think my sisters, they used frequent words of English in Gujarati language. So there is a real threat upon the Gujarati language too, in comparison with the Saurashtrian language. As far as Saurashtrian language is concerned, they have maintained their own identity, linguistic identity in their respective area. They are very strict in the sense. So that's why whenever I got the opportunity, whenever I get the opportunity to visit Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh and Karnataka, starts from Kuso, from Bangalore to Kumbakonam, Madurai, Thanjavur, Tirunelvel, Periyakulam and other areas. I used to grab the opportunity to meet our brothers and sisters. Second thing, I must mention that when first time visited the delegation of Saurashtrian brothers and sisters to this university in 2006, I think Damodaranji has initiated this particular movement. Damodaranji was the first one, along with Damodaranji, Radha Parshuraman, Sarojini, and our that musician, Setu Raman and other brothers and sisters. Yes, yes, yes. So there were seven people who initiated this particular movement. Subsequently, immediately they arranged the program in Madurai in 2006, then 2007 and 2009, when the then Chief Minister of Gujarat visited Madurai and addressed the Saurashtrian gathering. With the help of our Saurashtrian brothers and sisters, during the last visit of Prime Minister at Pondicherry in March 2018, personally we have requested on behalf of all of you that you have initiated, you have extended wholehearted support in 2007-8-9. Because why I am mentioning this? The then Chief Minister, Honorable Prime Minister Modi ji, was very much keen to extend all kind of support for collaborations between the Gujarat and the Saurashtrian brothers and sisters. Now we have requested during his visit to the Pondicherry, personally we have requested Honorable Prime Minister to be with us. I think it is likely that he is visiting Madurai in the month of September to inaugurate one project in the month of September. We have requested Honorable Prime Minister to address the Saurashtra Mahasangamam with the help of, but of course, with all segments of Saurashtrian brothers and sisters, starts from Bangalore via Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, all areas of the Tamil Nadu, all the districts. So it will get the good momentum as far as our identity is concerned. Especially our community is concerned, I think we have come out from that particular time when our community was struggling for the identity. Nowadays, at least we got the recognition. We have been succeeded to protect our identity, culture, cultural heritage and everything. So this is the right and the right time. Again, to roar in the area of entire Southern India. Friends, I must give the compliment to my dear friend, Professor R.B. Chala. As far as this particular activity is concerned, it includes cultural exchange, performing art and everything. Jalaji and Damodaranji, they are the real in charges of this particular project. Silently, without any kind of trumpeters, they are not the trumpeters, without any kind of publicity, they have conducted this particular project under the guidance of Professor A.K. Singh and my senior Professor Kamal Mehta sir. Really, I would like to congratulate R.B. Chala sir and Damodaranji at this juncture. Friend, as far as this particular project is concerned, I would like to request CIL officer, officials, Dr. Prem Kumar is with us. I think if we